I remember her telling me they worked together, and I was like, Jen, that's a bad idea. You should never date someone you work with.
It's been a wonderful weekend so far, and it's not over yet. And the sun came out. What a glorious day for the wedding. I want to start by thanking Mark and Jen for giving me the opportunity to speak and share a few thoughts on their very special day. I've had the privilege of knowing both of them, both on a personal and a professional level. And I'd like to think I had a very, very tiny part in them actually meeting. We'll turn the calendar back to 2006. I think it was the summer of 2006, and I had asked Mark to lead the recruiting initiative to bring new business analysts into our group. Now, Mark, being the classic overachiever that he is, not only found us an ace business analyst for the firm, but found the love of his life in the process.
Part of what Cindy talked about today was the history of us. And I wanted to talk a little bit about that tonight, because it really was a great way to start a relationship. So we'll back the clock up to July 21st, 2006, which I would point out was a Friday. And I say it was a Friday because only at Fidelity, our employer, which is the greatest financial services firm in the world, thank you, yep, turn here, you've seen the ads, only at Fidelity at 4 o'clock on a Friday would someone schedule an interview. So that's fine. So it's July 21st, 2006, and I'm one Spartan way in beautiful Merrimack, New Hampshire, and I stroll down to the lobby, and I was asked by a colleague to do a favor and to interview a business analyst who was a recent college graduate. Now, one thing about Fidelity is that urban legends develop. And stories turn into myths, and 5 years later, and 10 years later, truth, fact, fiction, it's all blends together, and no one really knows what happened. However, there are some people tonight who, where are they? Where's Barb in that table? Are they here? Oh, they're back there. Okay, so we have some historians in the room who were there during this time that should you choose, maybe after a few more cocktails, they know some of these stories and will validate my truth. So I did not hire Jen. I interviewed Jen as a favor to a colleague. So let's set that straight. There were no human resource issues, anything like that. So I went down to the lobby, and I'm watching that table right there very closely. I see Dave Brown probably doing bad things. So July 21st, I stroll down to the lobby, and there sits this very, very beautiful recent college graduate. So I sat down, we had a great conversation. Anyone that's done a lot of interviewing has a standard repertoire of questions, which I just let it rip and grilled Jen about how did she provide a great customer experience and what's her background, and she just rattled off every answer as if she knew what I was gonna say. And I left that meeting thinking, this is just an amazing human being. And I was so moved by this conversation that when I drove home that Friday, I thought that it was just really, really special. And I made a phone call. Barb Bully, would you raise your hand, please? You stand up. Stand up, please. Barb Bully, no, stand up. I'm sorry, I can't, thank you. Okay, so I made a phone call and I said, Barb, I gotta tell you, I had a really interesting experience today. I met this young girl named Jennifer Hampton. And I can't imagine what would happen, but this was just, I'm so excited about this. So Barb decided to decipher the facts. And Barb said to me, okay, you're 31, she's 22, she's really beautiful, you're saying she's really smart, she's very poised, let's not get our hopes up. And that is the support network that I am very pleased to have here tonight. So, July 21st goes by, life goes on, and we'll pick up that portion of the story in a moment.
From the very beginning, they just clicked. There are so many things that make them good together. Each, I think, is amazing in their own right, but together, they're like the dynamic duo. They complement each other, they support each other, they challenge each other. They also exposed each other to many new perspectives and some new interests. One of my favorite stories early on, very early in the relationship, it was a Friday afternoon, and I said, "Squires, what's up for the weekend?" He goes, "Oh, Jen and I will go on camping with our whole family. It's an annual event." I said, "Really?" Now, I've known Mark a while by this point, and he always struck me as more of the Westin, Marriott, Hilton, Omni type guy. But I have to say, he was genuinely happy and thrilled. He said, "It's going to be great. We're going to be camping along a riverfront. It's going to be tubing. There's a restaurant, a bar. There's dancing. It's going to be a hoot." Well, apparently, the weather gods were not with them on their first camping trip together. And I'll tell you, nothing spells love more than Mark Squires holding metal tent poles in the middle of a lightning storm, desperately trying to get a tent up to shelter his new girlfriend from the elements. You're all getting a visual, I see it. As we all know, though, relationships are easy in the beginning. What I call during the white lightning phase, everything's fun, upbeat, positive. And to their credit, both of them decided early on that they were gonna spend some time and let their relationship evolve naturally. So over the last 5 years, they've had wonderful moments together. They've had some challenges, of course, like every couple. And they've helped each other through some life decisions. Their relationship certainly has stood the test of time. And today, they are not only best friends, they're soulmates. But even after 5 years, the sparks are still flying, and I think they're more in love than ever. I think Mark's proposal to Jen was probably one of the most romantic stories I've ever heard in my life. Newport's always been a special place for both of them, so it was a natural choice for them to become engaged in Newport. To make sure he didn't spoil anything, he suggested a weekend away to celebrate Jen's birthday at Castle Hill. Nice. So Mark quickly turned on the project management mode, called the castle in, endeared himself to not only the manager, but pretty much everybody on staff, planning out every intimate detail.
It was just the most beautiful day. So he had surprised me. He told me we were going to Newport for my birthday, because he knows how much I love it down there. And that was actually where we had our first real date. And we went down and we had lunch, and he said, "I have three surprises for you. And the first one is our hotel room." And then he said, "The second one you'll get at 5 o'clock. So we went down and he was so nervous. He's like, "Let's go for a walk." I said, "Okay." So I thought it was a surprise birthday party.
So the setting, two Adirondack chairs overlooking the ocean at sunset, a table with fine linen, pictures of all happy times that they've shared together, flowers, champagne, wine. And if that wasn't pulling out all the stops, he then proceeds to remind her of the list that he had prepared early in their dating days, of the 51 things he loved most about dating Jen.
"When on our 51st day of dating, I wrote 51 reasons why I loved being with Jen. And so I read that to her on our 51st date. When we got engaged, I added 49 great memories of our times together since that time to just round it off to 100. So she had to sit very patiently and listen to all those 100 things. But it was really, really fun. And it was neat to go back and reread those 51 reasons and then to add all the things that we've done since then. So it was a really, really fun time.
All that before getting down on one knee to pop the question. So I'll step back and say, who could say no after all that?
He gave me a call and said, we're gonna go out for a beer. And we said, okay. He came to Derry. Went out for a beer and we got talking, and it took him about 10 minutes. Yeah. And he asked me, and everything was great.
Oh my
gosh. Yeah, he was very good guy, and the whole thing was very, very nice. Jen told us about him, and he was Jen was very happy. And Mark, he's a pretty natural guy, and it all worked pretty nice. Mark's just a great guy.
Quickly, I know you were out enjoying yourself.
Yeah, well, I think I had to come down here to get everything set up and do the pictures.
Yeah, the family gets along awesome. So, my mom always said she wanted us to marry people that she could spend holidays with, and she loves these guys. So
yeah, so hopefully she can spend holidays with them.
Oh, thank you. I love it.
Yeah. Works.
Yeah.
Works
very, very you. I love it.
I'm not wearing my necklace.
All right, Dad.
Determined not to have to get new shoes.
I think I love the shoes.
Probably tried 50 dresses on. But I'm a quick shopper, so we had like 50 on in one store in like 1 hour appointment. So we went three times looking, and finally we ended up back at Priscilla Boston, which is where we originally went, but I didn't end up with the dress that we originally liked there. So, and when I walked in, I saw someone wearing this dress. I said, that's kind of pretty. Can I try that on? So they said, yeah. So I tried it on. Of course, I was very confused. I had a couple of dresses now I liked, so we called my Uncle Gerard. And I was like, can you please come in? And he lives in Hingham. So he ended up driving up with my Aunt Lorraine, and he was the one that ended up picking the dress.
No way.
Yeah. And it's called Styles Hampton. It's my last name. So I was like, I think it's meant to be.
Oh my God, I feel like a bride.
You are a bride in about 1 hour.
How about that?
That's
definitely a car.
Okay. Have a look in the back.
Awesome. You think you can do that?
Everything about this dress is awesome.
I just think it's an awesome dress.
Mm-hmm.
It's an
outfit. Okay, a team job. You girls are stunning. I like those. I like them a lot.
You look gorgeous too. You look awesome. All right, now we just need the veil. Hi, Jen.
You have your lip like this.
Oh my God.
I know, right?
I want to cry.
She looks stunning.
Yes. Oh my God, I want to cry.
Yeah. No, it's over there.
No one can ruin their makeup.
I know.
They're a wonderful couple. They really are. We're very happy and feel very fortunate to be bringing her into our family, and I hope they feel the same.
I'm very happy for you and Jennifer's Mark, and
always keep smiling because life is worth that without. It's no good.
And
I wish you all the happiness.
That was perfect.
I'm Mark Vernon Squires.
I, Mark Vernon Squires.
Take you, Jennifer Lee Hampton.
Take you, Jennifer Lee Hampton.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
I humbly give you my hand and my heart.
I humbly give you my hand and my heart.
And pledge my faith and love to you.
And pledge my faith and love to you.
I will wish for the fulfillment of your hopes and dreams.
I will wish for the fulfillment of your hopes and dreams.
And will cheer your triumphs.
And will cheer your triumphs.
While promising unconditional support.
While promising unconditional support.
Through good times and bad.
Through good times and bad.
In the presence of our friends and loved ones.
In the presence of our friends and loved ones.
I vow to love and care for you.
I vow to love and care for you.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Jennifer, with this ring.
I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
That from this day forward.
That from this day forward.
You shall not walk alone.
You shall not walk alone.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I give you my heart.
I give you my heart.
Just mark and repeat after me. I have no greater gift to give.
I have no greater gift to give.
I feel so honored to call you my husband.
I feel so honored to call you my husband.
I feel so blessed to call you mine.
I feel so blessed to call you mine.
May we feel this joy forever.
May we feel this joy forever.
I think another factor that contributes to their rock-solid foundation is family and friends. They are loved by many, as evidenced by everybody here today. They have a large extended family on each side and a wide circle of friends. And I personally was amazed at how quickly and easily they were able to assimilate into each other's worlds. And I think more remarkably is their ability to continue to maintain and nurture all those relationships.
We drove by here on our way skiing, on our way home one time, and we just saw it. We thought this place was absolutely gorgeous. So we came up, and as part of my birthday surprise for the engagement, Mark got us a night up here and an appointment with Kim. So we came up, and we just fell in love with it immediately. We kind of just knew right away, so it was, couldn't picture a better place.
One of the most important things to us was just to have a place that our guests really wanted to be and could just have a splendid weekend. And every single person that's here, I think, at least that they've shared with us, is excited to be here. And the Mount Washington is just rich in history and just a beautiful, beautiful place. And we've already had a great time, and it hasn't even really officially started until now.
We went ziplining this morning.
Yeah, how was it?
It was so cool. It's so much fun.
Mark was nervous because when we were going down the rappelling, he didn't say a word. You knew that he was nervous because it was actually quiet.
We had such a good time. Then we came back and we sat at Stickney's and everybody was in and out. And it's just, it's the strangest feeling to be in this place and see your aunt and uncle and then your colleague from Boston and then your best friends you grew up with and all these different perspectives that people have brought here. It's just, it's really moving.
Actually, I met his family, his mother and father, before Mark was born. They came into Hollis and his mother said that I'm one of the first people she met. And I went to her house and there were cats climbing all over everywhere, on the table, on the counter. And I said, this is a lady I'm gonna like. And I don't know how long they'd been here, but then Mark was born. And I can't remember not knowing Mark. We've had so much fun, so many crazy experiences.
Now, I'm sure we all have favorite Mark and Jen stories, but I was told I had 5 minutes. Family holidays, cruises, camping trips, Patriot games, monthly dinner parties with the Hollis crew and their wives and girlfriends, Boston and Newport gatherings with Jen's college buddies, and lest we forget, the lake parties, pub crawls, and Vegas trips with the Fidelity crew. Mark and Jen are truly one of the most fun-loving and genuine couples I've ever met. I wish them a lifetime of laughter, happiness, health, and of course, love. Thank you.
Good job. If you've ever been in this situation before, if you've ever been in a moment, you know how dear it is to hold that moment at task. And I thought that it would be a fine time for Mark and Jennifer to do exactly that, to remember this moment by having time to absorb the moment, time to look at one another and say, wow, you look great. But also, it is going to be the only time that they will ever, ever, ever meet this way again. A moment to savor, would you say? I dare say there's probably not an architect in the world that could have created a more beautiful cathedral than the one that we have right now. So enjoy every moment of it and enjoy it as it changes because it continuously changes. The amazing thing about New Hampshire is that when a couple gets married, all they need is a justice of the peace. All they need is me, a bride, a groom, me. Why are you all here? I'm sure you know why you're here, but I'd like to take this opportunity to congratulate you all on being as important as you are. You are going to have a great day today. You are going to smile. There are going to be tears of joy, of laughter. It will be a wonderful, wonderful day. But as you are here right now to celebrate with Jennifer and Mark, make yourselves a promise, each and every one of you, that you will be here on the days that aren't quite as beautiful as today. That is the greatest gift that you could ever give to a new bride and groom. And maybe, just maybe, that's why you were invited.
Divine wisdom, eternal love, guide these two on their journey together. Keep them faithful and strong, able to bend like pines before the wind. Give them the wings of love to rise above petty differences and keep a song in their hearts. Let them witness life's beautiful radiance as the sun rises in the morning for another day of joy. And give them many moons and stars to count their blessings by. May God bless your marriage with a safe harbor, a place deep enough and wide enough to stay through the storms. May God make your marriage a map for exploring and a garden for growing. May God grace you with a heart to encourage each other and a laugh to enjoy each other.
I've never told this story before. I've always had an aversion, and this is due to the year in which I was raised. And forgive me, ladies, but I thought, and I hadn't before I went to medical school, that having babies was and I quote women's business, and I didn't really want to be there, but. By the time we got to number four, all those inhibitions had been removed, and there I was in the delivery room. And out comes Mark, and he says in newborn talk, we had to translate it, but he said, "I'm in charge." We couldn't believe it. I mean, we'd been around a while, too. But nevertheless, that pattern has sort of remained. Until today. And Jen, first of all, when you come into a room, there's a new light. It's a lovely light. It's soft, and it's affectionate. It's a remarkable transition, whether it happens in the evening or in the morning. You bring this light, which is marvelous. Secondly, when you laugh, the whole world seems a great deal better. All life's little problems disappear, and your infectious enthusiasm and your laugh just makes the world a better place. And then when I see you with your friends, I see someone who's concerned and loving and caring, someone who it seems to me has an amazing capacity to develop relationships that are deep and long-lasting, a trait that I admire in you more than I can say.
I do want to say thank you again for this opportunity, truly. And just be so proud of yourselves. Remind yourselves often, really, of the commitment you're making to one another. But these are just a few words I'd like to leave with you from me. Mark and Jennifer, treat yourselves and each other with respect, and remind yourselves often of what brought you here today. Give the highest priority to the tenderness, gentleness, and kindness that your connection deserves. When frustration, difficulty, and fear assail your relationship, as they do all relationships at one time or another, remember to focus on what is right between the two of you. Not only that silly little thing that at that moment seems so wrong. And in this way, you can ride out the storms when clouds hide the face of the sun in your eyes, remembering that even if you lose sight of the sun for a moment, the sun is really, truly still there. And if each of you takes responsibility for the quality of your life together, it will be marked by abundance and delight. So if you'd hold, join hands. Promises, promises, huge promises. Your first gift, eternity, the circle that will last forever, that will be unbroken. Be good to each other. Love one another. Thank you again. And so it gives me a great deal of pleasure as a justice of the peace, not only in the state of New Hampshire, but in this perfect place that you have chosen, to very proudly pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride.
And now,
Tonight's gonna be. Let me be the first. Good night. Tonight's gonna be. Mark Squires. Good night. Tonight's gonna be. Good night. Tonight's gonna be. Good night.
God go with you and bless you. May you see your children's children. May you be poor in misfortune and rich in blessings. May you know nothing but happiness from this day forward.
Said five words to me that would forever change my life, which is Jen Hampton starts on Monday. And he said that to me, my life would never be the same again.
Yes. to be the most awesome crowd I think we've ever had. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you.
We're trying to get him to come down to the cave. I'm still working on that.